Herb is an integral part of the mental development and the whole thought process. We feel like we're going to keep pushing this conversation, we're going to keep pushing this message. We believe in marijuana and we ain't going to stop until you do too.
At a youth, I was, I come from a very middle class background. Both of my parents worked till late. So I went to a very posh boarding school in England. And I remember vividly, I was in the middle of my O-levels in a very, very straight boarding school. And this was in the 70s, and things were a bit rough in the 70s when it came to institutions. So one day I'm grabbed out of my dormitory, and I'm pulled down some stairs by all these sort of nothing more than Gestapo prefects, because it was very, you know, on that sort of fascist vibe. And I got beaten by the headmaster for something I didn't do.
Wow.
And I was really vexed about it. And I was very chill. I wasn't, you know, a rebel until that moment. So I remember I went into the week. It was a weekend where I went home. I bought £2 of Indian hemp seed. Now, it's totally impotent. You can't get high.
Yeah.
So I went back the next week and I convinced everybody in the upper, yeah, this was it. So they all drilled holes. They all drilled holes in their tuck boxes. They got little plastic yogurt cartons.
Yeah.
And they all started growing. So these little skinny little buds would come up with a little marijuana leaf. Anyway, it didn't go so well from there, because these public schools are very paranoid of getting a reputation for drugs, because they lose all of their posh, rich clientele.
Potential clientele.
So the next thing is, in the middle of my O-levels, I'm dragged out of there, put on a train, and said goodbye. And I got expelled. So that was my first sort of slight involvement with marijuana. That was in 1976. Rich forever, rich with a loving family. Oh, rich forever, rich with ways, means, and strategy. Forever family, my treasure in a